Hello children, how are you? I think all you are fit and fine at your home. So let's start our new chapter from today, that is chapter 3, fiber to fabric. So before starting the chapter, I'd like to ask some questions from you. We wear different types of clothes during different season. Have you ever thought about the kind of material used for making these clothes? Did you ever thought that which materials are used for making your cloth? Why only certain type of dress material are used for clothing in any particular season? For example, in winter season we wear woolen clothes. During summer season we like to wear cotton clothes. So why the particular type of clothes we are wearing in particular type of season? Why certain clothes are smooth whereas others are rough to touch? Okay, if you touch jute items or silk cotton items, it is rough to touch. But if you touch silk item, it becomes soft. Why is it so? Why do certain clothes after washing dry quickly, whereas other take much longer time? And children, you must have noticed that some of the clothes take lesser time to dry up, but some of the clothes take more time to dry up. Why this is so? So all the answer of these questions we will found in this chapter. Okay, so let's start this chapter, fiber to fabric. Thus we see that there are different kind of cloth material or fiber. Most cloth materials or fabrics are made from cotton, some are made from wool or silk, whereas some others may be synthetic dress material. So children, in our day to day life, the cloth material whatever we wear is mainly made up of either cotton or silk or wool or synthetic fibers. Okay, so each kind of fabric is suitable for a particular use. For example, we need different kind of material for making each of the following clothing material, such as day-to-day wear, bed sheet, blanket, curtain clothes, towel, etc. So for these all materials we need different items, different fabrics to make. So now comes to page number 35. Here there is two activity, activity 1 and activity 2. So we will first study about these activities. To know this difference, let us perform the following activities. So in activity 1, you can see the aim of this activity is to know about the structure of various clothing material. So we have to know what are the structure of various clothing materials. Children, if you see any cloth material, either it is cotton material or silk or wool, if you see it carefully, you can see that the threads from which that fabric is made up of, they are passing with each other at a right angle. Okay, if you see it carefully. So one piece of each type of fabric, such as cotton, polyester, silk, wool, you have to take first and a magnifying glass. So place each piece of cloth on the table, examine each of them with the help of a magnifying glass. What do you observe? So you have to first see it carefully. You can see in each material the threads are passing with each other. These threads are also called yarns. These yarns are passing with each other at a right angle. Okay, now try to pull out the thread with the help of a pin or needle. This loose thread is called yarn. Children, now try to pull out one of the thread from that fabric. Okay, and this loose thread, that is called yarn. From this activity we conclude that fabric is made up of yarn arranged at right angles to each other. So from this activity, what you concluded? You concluded that fabric is made up of yarn, made up of thread, which is called yarn, and they are crossing with each other at a right angle to make any fabric. So fabrics are made up of yarn. Now comes to fibers. But what is fibers? To understand what is fibers, perform the following activity. Now comes to activity 2. So here the aim of the activity is to study the fiber of different fabrics. Material required, yarn of different kinds, magnifying glass. Take out a yarn from a piece of any fabric. Place the yarn on the table. Hold its one end with your thumb of the left hand and scratch the other end along its length with your thumbnail at the right hand. Children, first of all, you have to take out the yarn from any of the fabric and then hold it from one of your hand's thumb and the forefinger. Okay, after that, the other end you start scratching. So after scratching for few minutes, you will see this type of structure. Okay, so many small and thin threads are coming out from that yarn. This small and thin strands, these are called fibers. Yarns divided into small and thin strands, these strands are called fiber. Okay, so what we concluded from this activity? We concluded that we can now concluded that fabrics are made up of yarn of a particular kind and the yarns are further made up of fiber. So fabrics are made up of yarn and yarns are made up of fiber. Now comes to different kind of fibers. Thus we have seen that each type of fabric is made up of its own kind of fibers. Where do these fibers comes from? What are the sources of fiber? Of course, there are two sources of fiber. The first one is natural and the second one is synthetic. So we have two sources of fiber which are used in fabric making. Fibers which are obtained from natural sources like plants and animals, fibers which are made in factories or mill. So as I told you children, there are two sources of fiber, natural source and artificial source. Natural source of fiber, natural fibers are those fibers which are obtained from nature, from plants and animals, and artificial fibers are those fibers which are obtained from the chemicals obtained from petroleum product, okay, in factories and industries. They are called synthetic fiber. The fibers which are obtained from plants and animals are called natural fiber. Fabrics of fiber like cotton, jute, silk, wool are natural fiber. Cotton and jute fibers are obtained from their respective plants. Wool and silk fiber are obtained from animals. Wool is obtained from the fleece of sheep, goat, hair of rabbit, yak and camel. Silk fiber is drawn from the cocoon of silkworm. So children, yes, the fibers which are obtained from plants as well as from animals, they are called natural fiber. But the fiber which are synthesized in industry from simple chemical obtained from petroleum are called synthetic fibers. Fibers of polyester, nylon, acrylic, etc. are synthetic fiber. Why? Because they are prepared in factories and industries using chemicals obtained from petroleum product. Okay, so that's why they are synthetic fiber, because they are man-made. Men are preparing that type of fiber by using chemicals, that's why they are synthetic fiber. They are not obtained from nature. So first of all, now here it is, there is a flow chart of fibers. You can see there are two types of fiber, natural fiber, synthetic fiber. Natural fiber is again further divided into two groups, animal fiber and plant fiber. Examples are also here. So first of all, in class 6, we will deal with the fibers obtained from plants. We will deal with fibers obtained from plants, that is natural fiber. Okay. And about animals fiber, you are going to study in class 7. And about synthetic fiber in class 8. But in class 6, we will study about the natural fiber obtained from plants. So fibers from plants. All plants have fiber in their body. For example, cotton and mango have fibers on their seed. You have seen, must be. Maybe jute fibers has fibers. Jute plant has fibers in its stem. Banana tree has fibers on its leaf. And coconut has fibers called core on the outer covering of its fruit. Do you know, children, core is one of the very strongest and the hardest fiber. Okay, you must have seen that the brown color structure which is coming out from the coconut fruit, that is the fiber of coconut. And core is very strong fiber. Core is used for making floor covering, doormats, mattress, ropes, etc. So this is all about today's class, and from tomorrow we will study, not from tomorrow, day after tomorrow we will study the cotton, which is also a plant fiber. Thank you. Have a nice day.